Hello everyone. So in today's video, we are implementing Watershed Algorithm to segment out objects from an image. So I have previously downloaded some image for you guys. So here we have two images and we will segment out objects from these images. So as you can see, we have these two images with us and we will segment this object here from this whole image. So as you can see, we have a lady in both these images. We will segment this lady out of this image using Watershed algorithm. So I want you to download OpenCV before we start today's coding. So make sure you have OpenCV installed in your system. So let's start today's coding part. So here we have import OpenCV. CV2, and we have numpy, and also we need matplotlib pyplot and skimage.ir. So to read the image, you have to use OpenCV, that is cv2.imread, and here is the name of the image. So as you can see, I have 1.jpg image here, and I import this image here, and just using pyplot.plt, I am showing this image in my as an output here. Then after this, all you have to do is to convert your image. Also, when we downloaded this image is in BGR format. So to apply Watershed, what we do is we will change this BGR format to a grayscale format. So using cv2.cvtcolor, we will change this image to a grayscale image. So here img is a variable that we define above, and we assign this image to img, and here I am using img to convert the BGR color that I have in this image to a grayscale image. So after converting, as you can see here, we have an image in grayscale, and now I am setting a threshold value. So here you can see I am setting grayscale and threshold binary and threshold O2 as my threshold values here. So after setting the threshold value, you have to apply some noise removal techniques on the image so that we can remove the noise. Also, we will set our edges to detect the background and foreground of our image. So just have a look at this code here. In this first section of our code, we are removing noise, and to remove the noise we are using CV2 morphology X. So to remove the noise from your image, you have to use CV2.morphologyX. Just send the threshold value here. Here you have to send the morphology opening, and here just the kernel value, and the iteration is 2. Then we will just show this image using plot.imshow. Opening is the variable that to which I assigned the value, and here you can see the image, and in this image all the noise is removed. Then we will use cv2.dilate to get the background area. So what dilate basically does, it basically dilute your edges, and the area that we left with is the background area. So here you can see I am plotting this using imshow, plt.imshow here. I am plotting this image here, and as you can see the blue area, the purple area, it is, we are sure that this is a background area. Then we are saving this image in our test.jpg. Then we will in the same way we will go for the foreground area, but this time we will use another method, and we will use distance transform to get the foreground area. Then we will show this image. Let's have a look at this image here, and you can see the yellow part of this image. We are sure that this is the foreground area. It means the yellow section is our object. Then we will find the unknown region, and what to get the unknown region, all you have to do is to subtract your sure background with the sure foreground section. So sure background is this image and sure foreground is this image. So we will subtract these images and what we will get is this image. So as you can see, we get the edges of our image after subtracting background with the foreground. And here we have edges of our object. So now after getting the edges of our object, what we will do is upon here we also save our image, foreground image, background image, short, you can see here short background area, we save in test.jpg. okay, now we have to extract this object from our image. And for that we first read our image that is already saved, that is our original image, that is 1.jpg. Then we will read our segmented image, that is the segmented object. And here we save test.jpg and we are accessing this test.jpg here. So here we are loading this image. Now we are applying masking to this image. So here we have this image in the mask part, and what we are doing, we are assigning all those pixels that are having value less than 128 to 0, and those who are having value greater than 128 we are assigning it to 1. Then we will simply multiply this with our original image that we have in our that we downloaded, and now we will get a new JPG. So let's have a look at the image. So here you can see we get this image and we are clearly having a part of the image here. So this part of our image is our foreground part. So let's run this code again and you will get a clear view of our segmented part of the image. So here you can see we have an image, segmented image here. So let's have a look at the image that we saved here. So this we have three images now. So this image is our original image here. Okay, this is our original image. Then we segment this image here. So as you can see, this part is our, the purple part is our sure background part. Okay, and this one yellow part is our foreground part. Then this new image, after segmentation, we get this image as a segmented image. So as you can see, we are very this watershed algorithm is working very good on this particular image as it is segmenting out our object. Also, if you want to apply another, suppose you want that you don't want to access the object using background area, you want it to be accessed using foreground area. So just comment out and just save test JPG in this foreground data. So this time this segmented image is saved, and on this segmented image it will segment out your original, it will segment out the image. So let's delete these two images first, and we will run our code again. And then we will check what is the segmented part we get in our foreground image. So here you can see we have a slight subtraction also in some place, on some places. So just have a look at these images here. So this one is our original image we downloaded. Now this one is our foreground area, the code for which we are finding the foreground, sure foreground area, and this is our segmented image. So the difference is in this more area is subtracted, as in sure foreground we are getting this yellow as our, we are 100% sure that this is our foreground area. So we are getting this image after segmentation. So this is all we have in watershed algorithm. Hope you gain some knowledge from today's tutorial. See you in next tutorial, guys. Thank you.